It's Friday, September 7th, and here are three film choices for today. The first is Him Hereafter by the Sri Lankan filmmaker Asoka Handagama. He's a filmmaker who makes these beautiful, very refined art house films. This film played in part of the Cannes Film Festival this year. And this is the story of the aftermath of the civil war in Sri Lanka, a war that lasted more than 20 years and took a lot of lives and disrupted a lot of families. This is the story of a man who was a rebel fighter during the war. He comes back to his community, and of course there is there's a price to pay for having done what he did during the war. He's trying to reintegrate into a community, he's trying to deal with what he has done as a fighter, and he's finding that it's very difficult with the people who will not let him forget the past. It's told in a very restrained and refined way. It's not a sort of fast-paced film, but it is very beautiful, and I think it gives you a perspective on the aftermath of that particular civil war in a way that you will never get from the news headlines or reading even a book about it. This is really the emotional heart of the aftermath of that war. Kon-Tiki is from Norway, and this is the story of Thor Heyerdahl. Heyerdahl was an explorer, an adventurer, a man who wouldn't sit still in Norway. So what he did was he set out to take the same path that he believed Peruvian explorers did many centuries ago, from Peru all the way to the Pacific Islands on a raft. This had never been done before, to traverse that expanse of the South Pacific without the aid of motors and using only the tools they would have had at the time, a raft made of bamboo lashed together with vines, that sort of thing. He goes with a crew. They documented all as filmmakers. This was done in the 1950s. And it's really a terrific adventure. It's shot in a beautiful widescreen way. You get a sense of what it would be like to be alone on the wild ocean, in the middle of storms, in the middle of, when no wind happens and they are stuck in the middle of the sea. It's a really a terrific adventure. They're dealing with sharks and whales and all of the things that you encounter. And again, dealing with a man who is so driven to complete this mission that he will do it almost at the expense of his crew. It's one of the last great adventure stories, Kon-Tiki, great film from Norway. Wasteland is from the UK. This is the story of a young man who gets out of prison having committed a crime and falls immediately back into a world of crime. His friends are working class guys. This is outside of London, and they don't have much to do where they live, so they begin to think of how they can make some money. They decide they're going to knock over a working men's club, steal the money from the safe there, and try to make a better life for themselves. Now, it sounds like it has the bones of a caper movie. It's about a heist in a way, but it's not done in a sort of sexy, jazzy way. This is really how Ken Loach would make Ocean's 11. So it's got that sense of just the truth of living as a working class man in England, and where you don't really have a lot of opportunities. But what you do have, I think, is your friends around you. You've got the pub, of course, and they've got this one chance to try to get a way out, and it happens to be through crime. The film is really on the side of these characters. It's very sympathetic to them, and I think that's what really made me fall in love with the film. You get a feel for these men as they're trying to find the only way they can think of out of their plight.